Hello again guys, and welcome to my channel. Today I will be showing you how I made this embroidery hoop for my mum for Mother's Day. You'll need enough fabric to cover the hoop. You'll also need embroidery floss, a tapestry needle, scissors, pens and paper to map out your design, and fabric markers to trace your design onto the fabric. Once you've got all your supplies, get your hoop and lay it across the fabric and cut out a square that is just a tad larger than the hoop. Use the screw at the top to loosen the outer part of the hoop and spread the fabric on the inner hoop to start. Make sure your placement is to your liking and overlap the outer part onto the fabric. Tighten the screw and stretch the fabric. Now is the time to trace out your design. Ideally, you'd have the sketch prepared beforehand, or if you're more free-spirited, you can do either by eye. Here is where we can actually get started. Thread your needle with your choice of colour and start stitching. Don't be worried about pricking yourself, since these needles are quite blunt, so your fingers can get a bit sore after repetitive work. For the stem at the top, I use this lovely olive green colour, backstitching along to the end. This fabric only stretches along the warp threads, so horizontally. So bear in mind the type of fabric you have when stitching. For the flowers, I did somewhat of a deviated version of French knot. You can see the proper way to do them when I proceed with the blue flowers at the bottom. However, I feel that this version possibly allows for more texture. For the text below, I use this wonderful deep purple colour and a backstitch.
swimming pool, swimming pools. Now that you put her on a pedestal, light the fuel, light the fuel. Flying off the edge, it feels like, ooh, HD reality.
For the middle flower, I used a purple less deep than the former and a backstitch. In the middle of the flower, I referred back to the deep purple colour. In the middle, I did a French knot, then I extended the stitches up to the middle of the petals. After this, I filled in the remainder of space with the lighter purple. With this dark green floss, I use a backstitch for the stem. For the leaves, I do detached chain stitches or lazy daisies. And for the flower, I use the same technique with the yellow. For the next stem, I use a lighter green thread backstitched and blue for the flower, and the proper way to do a French knot. Last stem is dark green backstitched with a red flower, which I tried to support with leaves underneath and leaves encroaching on the sides. And for the silhouette, I use this brown floss backstitched. When you've completed your design, trim the edges of the outside and do a basting stitch around the border to secure and finish the loop. There can come a time where you're short of money, but you can never be short of ideas. This is a great way to give something sentimental and unique to a loved one. It can be however simple or complicated you like, it all depends on you. In total, this took me about 6 hours. I was rushing, so I definitely cut some corners and the perfectionist in me is dying, but I'm still pretty proud of the result. let's just put all the mistakes down to artistic license. Hopefully in the future I'll be able to show some more embroidery techniques. Thank you for watching. Bye.